Okay, so next important topic is error. So basically how to calculate error, how to minimize error, what kind of errors can be there. So it will be a series of lectures on error. So first let us define error. So error is basically difference in the true value and measured value of a quantity is called as error or error of measurement. So suppose this is a line and length of this line is 8.5 cm, and with the help of this 15 cm scale the measured value is suppose 8.6 cm, so error is 0.1 cm. Error can be positive also or negative also, and the value of error depends on instrument and some external factors such as temperature, pressure, humidity, because with increase in temperature, length increases, area increases, volume increases. So there are many factors, but the most important factor is what kind of instrument you are using. So an ideal instrument, remember, an ideal instrument will give you zero error, but there are no ideal instruments. So there will be error in any measurement which you will take with the help of that instrument. Also remember, there is one important topic, that is least count. So least count is basically the minimum value that you can measure from an instrument. Minimum value which can be measured. For a 15 centimeter scale, the least count will be 1 mm, because the minimum you can measure is 1 mm or 0.1 cm. So always remember, error due to any instrument depends on least count. The more the least count, the more will be error, and the lesser the least count, the less will be error. And always remember, if in any numerical if error is not given, then you can take the least count to be equal to the value of error. How to take it in numericals, we will cover in the upcoming slides. So what is error? It is a difference in true value and measured value of any quantity or any measurement. It can be positive, it can be negative. An ideal instrument is zero error, but remember, no ideal instruments are possible. What is least count? Least count is minimum value which can be measured from any instrument. And error due to any instrument is directly proportional to least count. The more the least count, the more will be the error. And always remember, if you have to report any measurement, then it should be in this form, that value is equal to measured value plus minus error. So basically this is measured value and this plus minus error. So suppose if I have measured the value to be 7 cm and the error in instrument is 0.1, so answer will be 7 plus minus 0.1 cm. So this will be the answer. So your answer can range up to from 6.9 to 7.1. So the answer can be anything between 6.9 and 7.1. So this is basically measured value and this is the error due to instrument. So coming to the next slide, suppose that R depends on two quantities. So R is depending on A and B, and suppose R is equal to A plus B, but I have measured A from an instrument which is not perfect. So there is an error del A in the measurement of A, and there is an error of del B in the measurement of B. So neither A is perfect, neither B is perfect, so R will also not be perfect. So for measurement of R, there will be value of R and there will be error in R. So how to calculate error while adding two quantities? So suppose R is equal to A plus B, putting value of R, putting value of A and putting value of B. So R plus minus del R will be equal to A plus minus del A plus B plus minus del B. So A plus B can be written like this, plus minus is common, del A plus del B written like that, and R plus minus del R. but r is equal to a plus b, so r will be cancelled out with a plus b, so del r is equal to del a plus del b. So for example, how to use this formula? Suppose a is given to be 1 plus minus 0.1, b is given to be 2 plus minus 0.2, and suppose r is equal to a plus b. So value of r will be a plus b, that is 3, and value of del r will be del a plus del b, that will be 0.3. So the answer will be 3 plus minus 0.3. Okay, so to calculate r, you have to just add up the values, and to calculate del r, you have to just add up the value of error. Suppose using the same value, suppose r is equal to 3a. So value of r will be 3 times a, so it will be 3a. We can also write it to be equal to a plus a plus a. So in summation, errors are being added. So error will be thrice. So del r will be 3 times of del a. So it will be 0.3. So always remember how to solve this kind of questions. This question seems easy, but when you try it with, you know, more number of quantities, then the questions are really tricky. So this way we can solve this kind of questions. Now coming to errors in subtraction. Suppose there is a quantity A whose value is A and error is del A, a quantity B whose value is B, error is del B, and R depends on A and B, that R is equal to A minus B. Neither A is perfect, neither B is perfect, so R will not be perfect. So suppose value of R is R plus minus del R. Now coming to the derivation, R is equal to A minus B, putting value of A, putting value of B, and putting value of R. So R will get cancelled out with A minus B, plus minus will be common. Again, see, in errors, in subtraction, the quantities will get subtracted according to the mathematics, but the errors will get add up. So del r will again be del a plus del b. So suppose a is given to be, suppose 2 plus minus 0.1, and b is given to be 3 plus minus 0.2, and suppose r is equal to b minus a, and you have to find out what? You have to find out r plus minus del r. So what will be value of r? R is basically b minus a, so 3 minus 2, so value of r will be 1. But what will be del r? For del r, there will be no subtraction. For del r, the errors will get add up. So 0.1 plus 0.2, so answer will be 1 plus minus 0.3. Always remember, in subtraction, errors will not be subtracted. Error will always get added up. So coming to some tricky questions now. Suppose r is 2a minus 3b, and I have given value of a to be 1 plus minus 0.1, and value of b to be 2 plus minus 0.2. So I have to find out value of r plus minus del r. So I have to find out what will be value of r plus minus del r. This is question mark. So for r, you can easily find out. The value is 2a minus 3b. So basically 2, value of a is 1, minus 3, value of b is 2. So 2 minus 6, value of r will be minus 4. And what will be the value of error? Now see, 2a minus 3b can be written like this. A plus a minus b minus b minus b. So del r will be written like this. There are 2 times a, so 2 into error in a. Error in a is 0.1, and error will always get added up. So plus, there are 3b, so plus 3 into 0.2. So answer will be 0.2 plus 0.6. It will come out to be 0.8. So what will be r plus minus del r? That is minus 4 plus minus 0.8. This is how you have to calculate value of error and value of quantity both. Suppose r is given to be a plus 2. Okay, and A is given to be 1 plus minus 0.1. In this case, value of R you can easily find out. A plus 2, so 1 plus 2 will be 3. And what will be del R? See, there is no error in 2. There is error only in A. So error in A is 0.1, so error in R will be 0.1. For constant, the error is taken to be equal to 0. So this kind of questions can be solved like this. Now, on the basis of this, you have to solve one assignment that I am sending you with this link also. Okay, or if you don't have assignment, then you can ping me on WhatsApp on this number 9867530456 to solve the assignment, because assignment solving is much more important to get clarity of this topic. In next class, we will take error in subtract, error in multiplication, and error in division. Okay.